This is Eddie. He came into our shelter last year, just as you see him, paralyzed.
Hello, boy. We'll try to help you. Try to get you out, okay?
But we made a video and put it on the internet, and a week later, the donations came, as did a wheelchair. Because of this, Eddie had a second chance and eventually found his forever home. This is what animal rescue is all about. I really didn't know anything about animal rescue when I first started volunteering at my local animal shelter. I just knew that we were having a foreclosure crisis, and because people were losing their homes, every night on the news they were doing stories from the animal shelters about how all the dogs and cats had to be surrendered. Because people had to move out of their homes.
Meet the fuzziest victims of the mortgage meltdown. Many homeowners facing foreclosure have no choice but to surrender their pets at shelters.
And it just seemed really sad to me, and I felt like I needed to do something. You know, what can one person do? Well, I can leave my home and drive to the shelter, and I'm a filmmaker, so I'll do some videos and I'll take some photography. What I discovered is that it takes an absolute army of people to rescue dogs and cats. It's not just one person doing one thing. It's a team of people working together for these animals. It's actually astounding, this army that is there in place to make sure that these animals don't get euthanized. Dogs and cats are part of our families in America. They are, you know, almost the purest expression of love and acceptance. Facebook was invented for cats. That's how much we love cats. As much as we love our animals, all across the country, millions of cats and dogs are euthanized every year just because they're unwanted. Some people say the local city shelters are sad places. I have friends that won't even go. Oh, it's too depressing. But, you know, it's at the shelter that I've seen the most amazing acts of human kindness, you know, really what's best in us as humans, the ability to love, to accept, and to save. And what it's like is one dog at a time, one cat at a time, the force of nature that it takes to get every animal out of the shelter into a rescue, out of a rescue into a foster, out of a foster into a forever home, so that these animals can become parts of families where they belong with human beings. So I want to make this documentary, How to Save a Dog, to show people what it takes to save a dog, or a cat, or a chicken, or any other animal that is unwanted and finds itself at a local city shelter. And I'm asking for your help. In addition to making the documentary, I'm also going to be making 20 to 30 instructional videos that'll be free on the internet and basically teach people about animal rescue and animal care and what everybody can do to help. Hopefully with the use of these videos and distributing this stuff, the public can get educated and therefore become part of the mission to save animals. Here in LA, we have been working the last several years to try to make the city no kill, which means we want to get to the point where no animal in a city shelter is euthanized just because they couldn't find a home. I was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer 3 years ago. And at the time, they gave me 2 to 4 months to live, and I started chemo. As soon as I was able to move around a little bit, I started volunteering more and more at the animal shelter. There's something that's been, you know, rehabilitating about it. Even though I'm terminally ill, it means a lot to me to go in and give what I can to something that I really believe in. You know, I don't believe that any innocent life should die just because we didn't try hard enough to get them a home. So I've been dedicating almost all my time now to this fight to try to make Los Angeles a no-kill city. So I'd like to take you on that journey. Thank you for your support. I hope you'll contribute and help make the documentary and the educational free online videos a reality.